My name is Juliet Asante. I'm the writer, director, executive producer of Silver Rain. And I think today is the seventh day of shoot. We are so excited because it's been exciting, really. I mean, the story is great. I have been blessed with amazing actors, people who've brought real dedication to the set, and people who've taken time to understand the characters and work at achieving the best. I have an amazing crew and the teamwork has been great. So I can say that, you know, we are achieving amazing things. I mean, the pictures are so beautiful. And so a lot of work is going into this, and I'm happy to say that we are making progress. This is a Pan-African production, and so Silver Rain has casted from almost 5 African countries: Ghana, Nigeria, Kenya, South Africa, and another African country that we are trying to confirm tonight. We are shooting partly here and partly in South Africa. We are trying to break some boundaries here, and I think that we are making good progress.
This movie, I think, will go far because the trend is quite different. You know, we're going down to the Kayayus. There are some people down there. Even if you want to help them, they think where they are is okay for them. Yeah, so it's a touching story. We have aspect of love in it. We have more of social conflict, as in politicians deceiving we guys on the streets. Let me put it that way. Yeah, so we're trying to bring out issues that we have to deal with but are being put aside. That is what the story is about.
Trying to achieve what we've been trying to achieve has been tough, I won't lie. I mean, the difference is that we are dedicated and everyone is working to achieve it. But, you know, trying to cast from all of these African countries has been really difficult. And trying to have access, understanding how the industry works. You know, a lot of actors work with agents, trying to go through the agents to get the actors to read the script. How much they charge, their fees, they have to travel here, their airfare, trying to get the right people, get to the right people. Sometimes we have to interview a lot of people and we are doing it long distance, and we have to have agents in every country trying to cast. We have 2 people from Nigeria, we have 2 people from Kenya, trying to get the South African. I mean, 3 times we've had an actor missed their flight from South Africa and then decided, something came up and then they couldn't just get on the flight and we had to get somebody else. So many things have been difficult and challenging. I think the difference is that we've been committed to achieving what we have set out to achieve. There's this particular time when my crew came to me, my casting director, she said, "Juliet, do you want to change this character and make them a Ghanaian because it's been so tough?" And I said to her, "Listen, we've done it this far. Don't give up when you're almost at the finish line. Get me a South African and get me a South African in Ghana. Get them to come to Ghana, get them on the flight. Whatever you do, just get this person on the flight." So it's been tough. I mean, trying to get the camera that we want to use, we wanted to use the equipment. We decided to go with the Red camera. Initially, we were going with the FS700R. We got the camera. The camera came to Ghana. We had to clear it, and then it didn't come with a card. And so we couldn't use it. My goodness, and this was the night before the shoot started. That whole day, we're running around trying to get the equipment out of the port. And then when it came, the card wasn't available. Then we decided right away that, okay, we're gonna do a Red. Did we have the budget for the Red? My goodness, we had to do some crazy math and moving things around. And then trying to get the Red wasn't easy because that camera is not very available here. And then when you get it, the accessories that go with it, trying to get the lights, 6K lights, all the things that we need to create daylight or night or move things around, it hasn't been easy. We have our DOP come from South Africa. He's really, really fantastic. He's done some great productions and he's used to international standards. And of course, we were not going to break the standards. We had to live up to those standards, and he expected no less and we expected no less. And he's been very happy so far. We've been happy, but he kind of also brought a lot of training to the crew and a lot of expertise and expectations that we had to meet to be able to achieve the kind of picture quality that we set out to achieve.
My main work on Silver Rain is to transform some characters, to transform them from what they are not to what we want them to be to suit the story. And one challenge I've already faced is making up a whole body to look something different. Trust me, it's one very difficult thing. Standing on your feet doing that the whole day, trying to make it look the same in every shot for continuity's sake and all that. Trust me, it's been very hectic, but then we're still on, and so far we're getting good shots and I'm happy for that.
It's actually a very good production, and with the sort of cast we have, you know, it gives us a bit of diversity. We also have to create the sets differently because it's not your usual sets that you find. So the sets and props, even though they've been a bit challenging to produce, we still managed to get that to make the movie quite an exciting story, you know, because we need a good picture quality. So all that works to get that right.
What makes the story a bit different and what I like about it is it touches on quite a couple of controversial subjects. For example, like it's got some political aspects to it. It's got even on some social subjects it touches up on, and it's actually just it's got a wide range of topics in which the story kind of covers, you know. And we've been running all around Ghana shooting different scenes. Sometimes we even go to like far locations and to extreme locations just for like one scene, you know. So it's been interesting to see a lot of Ghana as well.
I'm playing a character called Bruce. The story for Bruce kind of like touches, it's a bit of a social inequality. It shows that angle of the society without making that the subject. So Bruce kind of like finds himself moving from the life of affluence that he's used to, and kind of like progressively getting involved with a life of necessitousness, put it that way. Some, you know, the poor, yeah. So you see his journey going from high and mighty to understanding the realities of life and other humans beyond his class. So it takes you through his affluence, arrogance, into the humility of life as he gets to meet a girl from the lower class.
I did some effects, that's the saw injury kind of thing on her back, and I had to make sure it looked exactly as they were shooting with the lighting, temperature and everything in the room, so that it wouldn't have any different look and all that. I had to be fanning the artist all the time and all that. It's been very hectic.
If you're producing a prop, you're looking at the characters to produce the props. So we've had to sort of work magic, if you know what I mean, because we want the sets to be exciting. We want the film has to be gripping. So when you're watching it, you're like, okay, wow, where did this come from? So with the props and the set design, that's how we try to achieve it. Because we studied the scripts and we were working with the characters. So if you know the taste of the character or exactly what the character is supposed to portray, that's how you get the good sets.
It's been awesome. Art is universal, so when it concerns creativity and talent, you learn to blend all elements that you can. So naturally, you should be able to quickly take in things and become. So it's been fluid. It's only when we're offset that I remember some of these people are from other parts of Africa and not the same, you know, zone, West Africa, you know, South Africa, East Africa. On set, we are one. It's universal, it's art, it's creativity, you know. So our offset, we make fun of ourselves and our various accents, you know, like, hey, Charlie.
When I asked the director the first day who was going to play this role, I got to know it was Jose, and I was like, wow, Jose, going to play a Kayaye. Wow. I was really amazed. But then the first day we had to rehearse everything and we had the whole look, we knew that it was going to work out. And working on Jocelyn has been quite difficult, knowing she's a light-skinned person and we had to work on her every minute just to get her tone of skin and all that. It's It's been hard.
Working with Juliet Asante has actually been a very good experience because you learn new things working on every production. And because of the diversity of this movie, we've had to work on different sets, different locations, and create lots of special effects as well. It's been a really great experience.
Working with Juliet, it's been a great experience. It's good to work with a director that knows what she wants. And she's got a strong vision and we work well together. I think we complement each other.
Working with Juliet has been fun, trust me. I would love to work with her again and again and again. She's one director who knows what she wants at every point in time. She tells you, hey, that thing there, I didn't like it the way you did it. I want it this way, and you have to get it for it. If not, the camera is not rolling. And I love her for that.